What's going on, pop stars? I pray you all are doing well, and I pray you all are making the best of this quarantine situation. I hope that you guys are finding ways to keep busy, stay active, and love on your family, because that's what's more important. And of course, above all of that, putting God first. So anywho, I'm popping in because I want to share another smoothie blend with you. Today we are juicing beetroots to be exact. Along with it, we're going to be doing ginger root, and we're going to be doing an apple. Now, keep in mind, every time I share a blend with you guys, it doesn't mean that you have to put the same ingredients that I put together. There are many combinations that you can put together. I'm basically popping in just to share with you guys the health benefits of the combination that I put together, featuring the main ingredient, which is always the veggie. And then, of course, you can pair whatever fruits and stuff around it. So anyway, stay tuned. Before we begin, of course, I always like to tell you guys why and the benefits of why you're doing what you're doing. Because in life, if you do not know your why, then honestly, you're lost. You should always know the reason why you're doing what you're doing, why you're saying what you're saying, why you're feeling what you're feeling. Get down to the bottom of it. So that being said, these root vegetables and fruits that I have in front of you is a winning combination. So of course, let's start with the beets. Beets, I'm going to run down, of course, everything as far as benefits goes. And I'm just going to name a few because there's so many benefits. Like, I'm not going to make this a 3-hour video. So anyway, as far as the beetroots go, the beets has folic acid in it. And for those of you who are pregnant or trying to get pregnant, folic acid is very important because it helps to guard against spina bifida for your unborn baby or your baby in utero. And spina bifida is basically where it's a condition where the skin around the spine and stuff doesn't fuse together. And so you want to take a lot of folic acid, and beets has that, as well as like pinto beans and, you know, a lot of grains and things of that nature. Beets also help clean your colon out, which we all know is very important because you need to detox and just flush out from time to time. It also cleans the blood, which is the function of the kidneys. The kidneys goes in to filter out anything that the blood does not need and get rid of it. So beets is like the kidney's cousin or kidney's twin. It helps to boost your immune system, which we all know is the body's defense mechanism to warding off sicknesses. And in the event, God forbid, you do get sick, it helps to fight it and things of that nature. Beets are anti-cancer. They're full of iron, which is, of course, in your blood. It protects against heart disease. It's anti-inflammatory. It helps to lower blood pressure. And then, of course, it helps to boost memory. And we all can use that. Then, of course, we'll reach over to the ginger. Ginger root, as I've always been saying, aids in digestion, which, again, is great for helping to clean out your bowels, help you to process your food and things of that nature. It helps to relieve gas. It's good for premenstrual or menstrual cramping. I am a firm believer in it. That's what I used to take when I was growing up, and I had cramps that would put a horse down. Literally, they were terrible. And I would take ginger and make a tea with it. Just clean the skin, slice a piece of it. You don't need a big piece. Make some tea with some lemon and some honey and drink it. And it would take about 30 minutes for it to hit. But of course, I've wisened up and I figured out a faster, quicker way of doing it. So now, anytime I need it, I just cut pieces of it, like chewable pieces, swallow it and chase it with water, and it instantly knocks out cramps. Instantly, I'm living proof. Ginger also is good for nausea. So if anybody suffers from like motion sickness, or those of you who may be pregnant and you're having like morning sickness, ginger's your best friend. But of course, consult your doctor first. Ginger helps to fight cancer, and it also improves circulation. And then of course, last but not least, we have good old apple. Well, you know the saying goes, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Why is that? Because it's full of so many nutrients, so many properties. Let's start with fiber. Fiber helps to promote smooth bowel movements. Smooth bowel movements basically is you don't have to sit on the toilet and strain to push it out. If you get enough fiber in your diet paired with water, it will help move that stool all the way out. Again, just think of it as trash, discarded trash. You don't need to keep that stuff in your body. So it's you want to encourage it to come out as easy and as quickly as possible. Apples are also good with preventing cancer. It's good for your skin. It stabilizes your blood sugar levels. It's good for your immune system, good for brain function. And also, it improves eyesight. And I am also living proof of that because I go every year and get my eyes checked, and my prescription has not changed, meaning it hasn't worsened. It's either improved or stayed the same. And I've been wearing like glasses / contacts since the age of 16. That was a lot of years ago. And my vision has not gotten any worse. And I've even had, I think it was a couple years ago when I first started juicing, my doctor actually said my prescription actually got better. So juicing is where it's at, and that's the only reason why I'm popping in to share this stuff with you guys, because I'm a firm believer in if you put the right things in your body and take care of your body and give it what it needs, your body will take special care of you. Just do your part. Yes, you cannot avoid everything. Yes, you cannot prevent everything, but you have a great deal of control as to what your body can and, you know, can avoid and what your body will help fight. So just do your part and put the right things in, and then you get the right things out. So anyway, enough of that, on to the blend. Okay, I am back and I have everything cut up and ready to go. As you can see, that's the beets, and I cut up the entire thing, roots, stems, and leaves. All of it is full of nutrients, so no need to discard it. It looks so pretty. Look how gorgeous that is. And then, of course, I have the ginger and then the apple. And then, of course, we can't forget a cup of water. Mine is room temperature. All while using my Oster blender. All right, let's get this smoothie started. And of course, you guys, I always say I put the softer ingredients to the bottom first, just to allow the blade to gain some momentum before it starts crushing everything, and so it doesn't stress. So I'm putting the apples in first, because pretty much all these ingredients are kind of hard, but you just use your best judgment. And then the ginger, just because they're all in the same bowl. Then I'm putting in the beets. Along with the roots, stems, and everything. And of course, last but not least, the water. And then we're ready to blend. Beautiful and red and healthy this is. Oh my gosh. No lumps, no chunks. As I keep saying, you do not need a fancy juicer. All you need is a blender that has a blade and let it run for about a minute. Look how pretty. Look how juicy. And more importantly, look how healthy. No, you do not have to adjust your screen. What I did is I put all the juice back in the blender because we tasted it and it wasn't bad, but we wanted it a little sweeter. So I just wanted, of course, keep it real with you guys and let you guys know that I had some pineapple cut up in a bowl. So I put about, I use an ice cream scooper because it was just handy at the moment. So I put about 4 or 5 scoops of pineapple in here because we wanted to taste just a little sweeter. Now, it wasn't nasty by any chance. We taste more ginger than anything, which we actually absolutely love. But like I said, we wanted it to taste just a little sweeter. So we add some pineapple to it. So guys, like I said, I was just popping in just to share another great smoothie recipe with you to help keep each and every one of my pop stars healthy and encourage you guys to continue to put the great things into your body so you can get the great things out of your body and, of course, get rid of bad things that are in your body. But anyway, I want to thank you all for tuning in. Please hit that subscribe button when you like the episode. Give us a thumbs up. And if you have anything you want to share, please leave a comment down below. Until next time.